So here, this one's a lot more complicated. What we're going to say here is we need to find the KC value for this equation here. And we're going to call this KC4. This will be KC1, 2, and 3. Since we're going to need some room to do this, guys, I'm going to take myself out of the image so we have more room to work with. So our best strategies for a question like this is, since we're trying to isolate that equation above, we have to look and see, where do we see each one of these elements? So what we need to do first is find H gas. And we're going to notice that we see H gas right here. Now, we have to manipulate this one in red so it matches up with this one in blue. So what two changes do I need to do to it? First, the H in red is a product, but we need it to be a reactant. So we need to reverse the reaction. Once we reverse it, we also need to realize that there's a 2 in front of this H. But over here in the blue box, there isn't a 2. So we need to divide by 2. And we just said dividing by 2 is the same thing as multiplying by a half. So we have to reverse it and multiply by a half. Okay, remember, dividing by 2 is the same thing as multiplying by a half. So now our equation becomes H gas gives me half H2 gas. When we reverse it, K becomes 1 over 11.8. And because we multiplied by a half, half becomes the power. And just remember, half power really means square root. We're going to say that this right here got manipulated, so we no longer care about it. And remember, we did all of this so that the red H gas that we have matches up with the H gas in the blue box. We're basically trying to manipulate these three equations so that they look like the compounds in the blue boxes above. Next, we're going to see, where do we see BR gas? Here in the blue box, it's a reactant, but over here, it's a product. Also, here in the blue box, it doesn't have a coefficient in front of it, but here it has a 2. So the two changes are the same. We need to reverse it so it becomes a reactant 2. And we need to divide by 2, which is the same thing as multiplying by a half. So this becomes BR gas gives me half BR2 gas. So we reversed it so it becomes the reciprocal. And we multiplied by a half, so half becomes the power. And remember, half power is the same thing as square root. Finally, HBr, where do we see HBr? Luckily, we see HBr in only one place. We see it right here as a product. So they're both products, so that's good. So there's no need to reverse. But there's a 2 in front of that HBr. So what do we need to do? We need to divide by 2, or same thing as multiply by a half. So this is going to become half H2 gas plus half BR2 gas gives me HBr. Since I multiply by half, this is to the half power. Half power is the same thing as square root. What we're going to do next is we're going to cross out intermediates, things that look alike but is a product in one equation and a reactant in another. So we're going to say here, this H2 is a product, this H2 is a reactant. So they're going to cancel out. This half BR2 is a product, but this half BR2 is a reactant. They cancel out. Whatever doesn't get canceled out comes down. So what didn't get canceled out? H gas didn't get canceled out. BR gas didn't get canceled out. HBr gas didn't get canceled out. And look, the equation we just isolated matches up with the equation above. Now all we have to do is, we're gonna say KC4 for our missing equation equals KC1 times KC2 times KC3. So basically all we have to do here is we have to multiply each one of these right here. So multiply this times this times this. Multiplying all three of them will give us a KC4 value of 4,526.19. Hopefully you guys were able to follow along as we did this problem. Just realize, the equation with the missing KC value is the one we have to look at. And we just looked compound by compound. Look to see where do we find them in the given equations below. When we're able to isolate them, you would just multiply all their K values together, and that will give us the overall K value for this equation we're looking for in the first place. So just remember the tips that we did. If you reverse it, K becomes a reciprocal. If you multiply by a number, that becomes the power. If you divide by a number, then it becomes 1 over that number as a power. So if you divide it by 5, it'd be multiplying by 1/5. If you divide it by 4, it'd be like multiplying by 1/4. Those would become the powers. Just remember those small little principles, and you'll be able to get these questions correct.